Sadcast.
Sadcast, coolest podcast in the world. My name is Billy, and we have Mr. Suit next to me. What's up, guys? It's another week. Another week has gone by on this beautiful planet we call Earth, and I'm feeling groovy. You feeling groovy? What's up?
Yeah, that's the groove.
Yeah, dancing, hitting a little dance on them.
A little wiggle. I like watching the
what?
The tentacles.
Yeah, they start dancing and shit.
They get into the groove with me.
Yeah, man, it's weekend, Mr. Suit. Shit starts getting...
Maybe it'll be new suit, Mr. Suit, soon.
Yeah, new suit.
Thinking
suit.
I gotta get that swagger update.
Yeah, yeah. Got
a
prestige.
Like, it's like prestiging or like unlocking a whole new DLC area.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
I'm rocking with it, bro. I'm ready to see the new Mr. Suit variant. But as always, how the fuck you been, bro? What's your week looking like? How you been?
Good.
Good. That's good.
Tired, but
yeah.
Well, I think everyone's tired.
Potentially.
I think I had this conversation recently where I was like talking to my buddy and I was like, bro, every day I'm just like, I'm tired, I'm sore, like everything like sucks. Like it feels like I feel like shit. And I was like, I don't know if I'm sick or if this is like the world's biggest joke that the boomers are playing, where they never told us after you just hit the age of 30, you're never okay again. Like, could you imagine that was just some gatekeeped secret, like some gatekeeping shit of like, yeah, once you just hit 30, you're always tired. You're always sore. You just never feel good.
It's funny because you mentioned that the last episode, so it must just still be, I mean, you're still 30, so.
Yeah, I haven't
I wouldn't
that
know.
Hasn't changed.
One day I'll know.
Soon, someday.
Yeah.
You'll catch up.
But,
Nah, I watched some movies.
Okay, I got one I saw in the theater, so.
Yeah, oh, in the theaters.
Yes.
Oh, Mr. Fancy.
Mm-hmm.
I just watched some shit on Amazon.
Okay.
Which, you still have my Amazon sign in, right? So you could probably.
I think so, yeah.
Like, you should see if you could watch this movie. It's called Bliss.
Bliss?
Yeah, B-L-I-S-S. Bliss. Okay. It's with Owen Wilson and some woman I don't remember the name of.
Is it a comedy?
No.
Really?
It's surprising, right? It's an action, kind of action-y. You know what it gave me the vibes of was Don't Worry, Darling.
Owen Wilson in an action movie?
It's not really like action per se.
Drama,
yeah. Okay. I would call it like suspenseful drama. It's a mind bender.
Wow.
Yeah, wow.
Wow.
It's it is a mind bender. It reminded me a lot of Don't Worry, Darling. It's like this whole concept of they're living in a simulation.
Is it new?
No. You know, it's funny. I've never heard anything about this movie, but apparently it was like, I think, 2021. Or maybe 2022, actually. I don't remember. Okay. I mean, it's newer. It's not like, no, bro, it's from 2005. Like,
right.
It's new-ish. But the premise is really interesting. They're in a simulation. Apparently, the woman he's with is the inventor of something called a brain box. Literally a glass box full of brains.
Oh, shit.
And they, like, put a hose on their face, and then there's little tentacles that like into their brain.
This is right up my alley, bro. I love weird shit. I'm glad you're watching weird
and
shit.
They enter like the simulation where it's like they have like fake generated people and like, you know, the point of it was like they live in a utopia right now.
Okay.
But people are so complacent with the utopia now that they're starting to complain, even in a perfect world.
Right.
So she invents the brain box, which puts them in a simulation that's like what we live in now, where it's just like, you know, barely livable minimum wage, homelessness, drug abuse.
Okay.
Like, it's just the world.
Right.
But they create that so that people will go into it and experience this shitty world. And then when they come out, they are like, wow, I appreciate what we have, kind of thing.
Interesting. So, and I guess that the name kind of makes sense then, too.
Yeah.
Bliss.
Yeah.
So, what?
But it's crazy because the mind bending part is like, you don't really know, like, the way they leave it, it's kind of like they leave it like Don't Worry, Darling and like Inception.
Right. Inception's
amazing. They don't give you closure.
Okay, yeah. Because they want you to just like think about it.
Right. So it's like when they disconnect from the brain box, the way they're doing it is they take like these they're crystals, they're gems.
Mm-hmm.
And what they're doing is they're like eating these gems.
Yeah.
Which gives them the ability to control the simulation.
Right.
So they can like move like fake people around and stuff. But as it goes, it's kind of funny because the exit, they have to like snort 10 blue gems, basically, is how I'll put it.
Right.
But the vibe I got was they start to do this like, was any of that real or were they just on like a drug trip?
Right.
Like, did they even actually like, were they even throwing people around or were they just like high as fuck and like, you know, like.
So what's Owen Wilson's part in this?
He plays the lead guy that works a dead end job, ends up getting fired, mm-hmm. meets this woman who's like, oh, you're a real person. You're real. And this is a simulation and I'm going to take you and, oh, you're my true love. And
so there's like a romantic element to it. Like there's like a love interest.
Yeah. A little bit.
But you don't know if they're both real.
Or no, are you they? Do. They're
both real people.
Yeah, from like the first 10 minutes, they both established they're both real.
Now, they kind of missed out on calling that movie Brain Box, I think. Because if it was called Brain Box.
That's such a fire term.
I think I would have like
Brain Box.
Seen it. I mean, it's, well, Bird Box.
Right.
Damn, because Bird Box was, or yeah, Bird, wait, is it called, isn't it called Bird Box? It's Bird Box.
The one on Netflix?
Yeah.
Is it Bird Box? Wait.
I thought it was called
Bird Box. Is it Bird Box? Box?
Bro, I'm Googling this shit. I swear to God, that shit was called Bird Box.
No, wasn't it?
I never seen it. That's a thing. Yeah, Bird Box 2018.
Okay, it was called Bird Box.
Yeah.
That's such a crazy, like, as soon as you said it, I was like, yeah, that sounds right. But then you doubted it. And then I was like,
when a mysterious force decimates the population, only one thing is certain. If you see it, you die.
Yeah.
The survivors must now avoid coming face to face with an entity that takes the form of their worst fears.
A bird. In a box. That's the one where they got to be like super quiet or some shit, right?
Is that it?
Yeah, I thought so. Where it was like they were all sneaking around and trying to be quiet.
Yeah, I just thought that came out. I didn't know that was already 2018 that came out.
No, yeah, that was before COVID. I think they made another one.
Right.
Or something. Bird Box, the reburdening.
Bigger box, bigger bird.
Bigger box, bigger bird.
I don't know. But Brain Box would have been cool.
Brain Box, yeah. That's what the invention was called.
So whose brains are in this box?
I think they just grew them.
They grew the brains?
Yeah, like the artificial. Because they have like, so what she was mentioning was three things that happened to make the world a utopia.
Okay.
Which was like artificial biology. Mm. So the ability to like print organs or create organs, whatever.
Can we do that in real life yet?
Kind of.
Because like, can't you clone shit?
They can clone, but what they can do is they can like use organ tissue and 3D print like internal parts and stuff. Like small things like heart valve flaps and stuff. But Whoa. Like we're talking like they could like print brains. So, or like grow brains.
Right. We're not there yet.
No. And then there was like one other thing, and then apparently asteroid mining, like they discovered they could mine asteroids, and then the guy that mined the first asteroids and started the asteroid mining company just started giving his money out for free because he had so much money. He was like, I don't know what to do with all of it, so he just started giving it out to people by the handfuls.
Do you think that there will be a time in our lifetime where we could just like pull up to the mechanic shop and be like, okay, I'm looking for a new valve. What is it called?
New heart valve.
I need two new heart valves. I need to re-axle my left leg. And I mean, I feel like we're kind of there, aren't we? Like, isn't that kind of how it works? It's just not as like...
Not as casual.
It's not as... Yeah. You have to actually have something going on. And
yeah, so, you can't just be all like, yeah, let me get three heart valves, a new ear, tongue.
It'd be kind of crazy, like...
I will say that that made me think of I hurt my arm.
Okay.
And I don't know what I was just programming, doing my job, and I like
go get a new
muscle
one
or some shit. Yeah, right. And I was like, I think it's my rotator cuff. And then I stopped and thought about it. I was like, bro, is a rotator cuff a part on the car or is that my arm? Like, doesn't that sound like?
Yeah, that looks like it's gonna be your rotator cuff. There, you're gonna want to replace
that.
Doesn't
that sound like a car part?
Yeah. Like, well, isn't there like a there's something like that on a car. I'm guessing there's got to be a cuff somewhere.
What, it was just funny because it was like, it's like, that's where the wheel attaches, the rotator cuff, right?
Yeah.
Like,
where is that? Your left or your right cuff?
Where I hurt myself is over here, the left.
Okay.
It was like right up on the top here. I just had this terrible pain. I've still kind of got it. I can't, like, I can't get a lot of, I can't go about higher than this. It starts to hurt. I don't know what I did. I fucked some. This is, dude, this is that 30 thing. I just woke up and my arm was falling apart. Yeah, I woke up and my arm was like,
no, sorry.
Nah, not today, chief.
But maybe you could like
go to the mechanic. Yeah, I need a new left rotator cuff.
That would be actually fucked up if like you went to the mechanic and you accidentally said, I need a new rotator cuff on your car and they replace your arm.
Yeah, well, like, that's not a part on a car, apparently. I looked it up.
Oh, you did look it up?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's not. Rotator. It should be. Like rotator something is a part on a car. Right. I'm not a mechanic.
Alternator.
Yeah, the alternator. No, not the alternator.
The alternator cuff.
The alternator cuff. That's where you cuff the alternator in.
Right.
Yeah, I think that's called a mount.
We're car guys. I mean, yeah. We know what the fuck we're talking about for sure.
Yeah, it looks like your car butthole's putting out blue smoke.
Yeah, actually, funny enough, I was at the mechanic today.
Yeah.
And nothing happened.
Oh.
Like, nothing. They
couldn't fix it?
Well, okay, so 2 weeks ago, my tire was like flat. Mm. So I went in, got a new tire.
Yep.
In and out. Quick, shout out the dudes over there. I was calling a bunch of places, you know, trying to get prices. And they were the cheapest price, but I just got the left one replaced.
Right.
And this was just, I think it was actually last week. It was recent. And then, yesterday, okay. First of all, the weather yesterday was weird because I woke up and it was just like green grass, like beautiful out. And then by 4 p.m. there was a fucking blizzard. And then overnight it was like a foot of snow.
I gotta move north.
Dude, it was crazy, bro. It was literally insane. I miss snow.
We don't get no snow. We got rain. That's what we got when you were getting snow.
Yeah, it was crazy. And like, so when I woke up, it was like I had to shovel my driveway and all the shit I wasn't even expecting because I just figured, I mean, we're mid-March. Like, we gotta be done with the snow shit, right? No. But I think that might, hopefully that had to have been the last.
No, the last we'll get snow in April.
Either way, it like snowed.
You know we will.
It was so heavy. The snow was so compacted. And then now it's all melted already. So it was just like, it was super like a super fucking sporadic. Oops. Roller coaster. I'd be hitting this thing all the time.
I know, right?
It's just whatever.
Just in the recording. So, but the
way that the snow ties into the story is like, you know, I was driving yesterday in the snow and my right tire was reading at like 18 PSI. And I'm like, what the fuck's going on? And I was almost just going to like say, fuck it and deal with it. But I was like, you know what? Let me like stop driving and like not fucking crash. Cause like that's so low at that point, it could just like blow out. And
what are your tires supposed to be filled to? Isn't it a 32. Little lower? Oh,
32.
I think mine are supposed to be like 38 or 36. I wonder, well, you got low profiles. Right? Your tires are like low profile ones. They're like thinner.
I don't know.
Oh, okay. Well,
all I know is it's supposed to be 32 for mine.
Yeah. My car complains when they're at 32. My car will be like, your tires are low. Huh. So like, but I've got like each really tire. Big, like they're like.
Maybe it has to do with the fact that my tires are bigger.
Yeah. Cause that's why I think, maybe that's why I keep thinking you got low profiles. Cause you got like bigger rims. So the tires are a little thinner.
So yeah, my shit's like, it'll start beeping at me if it goes anything lower than like 30. It's supposed to be at 32. And then it's nice though, because when I fill it up, when it gets to 32, it'll like, there's like a, somehow it just has a smart sensor that like, if you fill it up, it'll like stop.
Oh.
Which is nice. So you don't.
That's actually really
so
handy,
a tire doesn't blow up in your face, because that would be awful.
Bro, did I tell you that scary time that I accidentally put like fucking 48
okay,
into
hold
my
on.
Tire?
Hold on. We'll get there. Oh, that's crazy. You got to tell me about that, because that's nuts. Hold on. Okay.
Yeah. Now you got to know, right? You're like,
well, I'm hooked on that. Cause my shit wouldn't even let me do that if I wanted to.
No. But yeah. That was funny.
I went to this place and I was like, okay, like let's replace this tire. They said they had the tire, but it turns out it was my rim.
Right. Okay. So yeah, your rim's like bent.
So yeah. In three different places. I don't know.
You just be driving on curbs?
I don't know. I don't know if it's like drive. Like, so the only time I like remember when I hit curbs is drive-thrus. So I'll be like
all the time though.
I'll like cut like left too early, and then I'm like hitting that. But it was on the right side, so I don't really know. But the guy was saying like, yeah, if you had like, if it was just one, like we could probably hammer it down. But since you have like all these indentations here,
wait.
Yeah,
it was on the. The tire right now, that's the problem, is on the right side?
Right side front.
And when you go through the drive-thru, you're turning left, so you'd be hitting. But when you got your tire fixed, they rotated your tires. So your left side driver would go to your right side front.
What do you mean rotated the tires?
Every time they do any work on tires, they rotate the tires in your car. That means they take them and they move like your back left to your back right to your back left to your front left to your front right. Like they rotate all the tires. Yeah.
Oh my God, bro. You're going to... We're gonna, you thought they meant they... Yeah.
We had this conversation before.
We did?
Yeah. When I was talking about my car tire, I had a problem with mine. We've had this conversation. That's what I thought.
Interesting. Okay. Well... So, yeah, I don't know. Whatever tire is
what. That could be why. Because, like, if you were hitting them with your driver's left side, they would have moved
And, like, I looked and I saw, like, clear as day, there was fucking, like...
Bends or...
Yeah, yeah. It was, like, scrapes, kind of. And so, I guess the rim is now... It's leaking air because it's not, like, a perfect rim now.
Yeah, it's not, like, sealed.
But they gave me, like, some company that they go to that, like, they, like... They like melt the rim down and like smooth it out. There's some process they do that, and it's going to end up being a little bit cheaper than just buying a whole new rim. But
rims are expensive.
Yeah, and it's like,
but it'd be a good excuse to get some spinners.
I could do that. That would be crazy. The ones I have now though are nice, and it would suck if I had to like if I had to get a new rim. That would mean I'd have to get the new rim, and then I'd have to go back to. It was called like Chicago some wheels or something. I don't know where it was when I first got the car, 2019. I got it, and then the first thing I did was wrap the wheels black because I liked how that shit looked, like, murdered out.
So you'd have to go get them wrapped again.
Yeah. Yeah, I would.
And you'd also have to buy four rims so they matched. So it'd be like, instead of just fixing one, like, spending four.
So I just thought, like, something was going on with, like, my tires, but it turns out I'm the problem. Apparently, I'm the problem.
I'm the issue.
Because I guess I don't know how to drive, but... that was today. And now, and one other thing before I hear this 48 PSI story is,
I don't think it was actually 48, maybe like 45, but
okay. That's still crazy.
That is.
Apparently I had a magical, mysterious, spare tire that appeared out of nowhere today.
Well, like, where's your spare tire normally supposed to be? Cause you said you looked, but you never saw it.
Exactly. So, last week, when I went in, same place, I looked with the dude in the back, didn't see it.
Like
I'm saying
under the trunk or whatever?
There's even a spot where the wheel goes.
That was like empty?
Empty, okay. So there's something going on because...
I wonder if they just had a spare. I wonder if they meant it was like their spare, like they had a spare.
I don't know because they said they found it in my car and they didn't charge me for the spare because it was mine. And last week I went in... And they said, yeah, you don't have, it doesn't look like you have a spare, so let's just put on a new tire. And I was like,
okay. Have you gone to any, like, any mechanics?
Since a week ago?
Yeah.
Nope. They might have just put one in there and then forgot. I don't know, dude. Or it's possible that it just materialized.
Right. There's just some appeared. Dude going around your neighborhood, like, breaking into cars and putting spares in.
It's like he's like the car.
The spare fairy.
The spare fairy. That
would make the most sense.
I don't know if maybe it was hiding in a corner because my trunk is pretty like long.
So big a tire can hide in it.
Well, it's just pretty, you know, the spare is pretty small.
Yeah, it's gotta be the size of a fucking tire though.
I don't know, dude.
You wouldn't have drove.
Yeah.
You told me you were like, yeah, I'm driving there in a spare. I was like, oh my God, like that's the scariest shit. Because spares aren't made to go like
far,
and then it's like
you're driving. My car is tweaking right now because like if anyone has or had a Nissan, they know like especially these new ones, like they got a bell and whistle for everything, and that means that the alarm system is like super sensitive. So like I'm talking like I'll go to a drive-thru and get food and put the food in the passenger seat.
And it freaks out.
Yeah.
It's like, there's a passenger. Put the seatbelt on.
It's got a bunch of crazy shit like that. And one of them being when anything's going on with the tire, it starts alerting. So the whole time I'm driving, it says, see manual or something. It's like.
Who still has the manual?
Yeah, exactly. It's like something like, you know. Abort mission right now.
You're gonna die.
It says like the tire is like not the right size. I'm like, I know. I literally know that. So I don't know. Shout out Nissan though. Like the car's been good and it's just.
Well, when we go places, we'll take Ayn
mm-hmm.
and he'll sit like a human in the seat
Yep. Got to strap him in.
The whole time, bing, yeah. bing, his fat ass is setting off the passenger alarm.
So after it starts binging, though, how long does it do it for?
It just does it.
Okay, so we share that same thing because...
It's for the seatbelt for the passenger.
Yeah.
For the driver. It'll be annoying. Other things like tire pressure or check engine, whatever, like low voltage, like it won't. It'll do it like once.
Yeah.
But like for the seatbelts, it is trying to annoy you.
Have you ever had a homie get in the car and not hear the dinging and like just be oblivious to it?
Oh, it don't matter because I hear it and I'm immediately... Like sometimes Mrs. Suit gets in the car and she doesn't put her seatbelt on right away. Put it in the drive and it starts ding, ding. And I turn and look right away. I'm like,
seatbelt!
Seatbelt!
Yeah, no,
it's... Do you remember going anywhere with Charlie and be like, seatbelts?
Yeah. I mean, seatbelts save lives, but it's just like, wow, do they... They must save a lot of lives because...
Yeah, those alarms. And they don't give you any... It's not... It's like you put that bitch in drive.
They don't give you a chance. You're not even out the driveway yet.
No, and it's already like, you're not wearing your seatbelt. Like,
yeah. I was going to put it on in a second.
It's like, I get it. Sit in the car, put your seatbelt on, but then it works. Turn the car on.
It works. That constant dinging. Because what will happen is it'll ding, it'll go. It'll go for like probably 5 minutes. I've tested it. I've like driven in a parking lot, just kind of like
in a circle,
put it in neutral and just kind of let it rock and see. And it was like 5 or 6 minutes and then it'll stop. But when it stops, it only stops for like 30 seconds.
Yeah. And then it just goes again.
Right back at it.
That you're like, oh, it stopped. Ah,
yeah,
fuck.
Yeah, I know. I mean, I just put my seatbelt on and I'm just like, whatever, you know, fine. I guess I'll put my seatbelt on.
You know, what's more extra is the people that don't want to wear a seatbelt and they like put it, they go behind them.
That's a little extra.
And
yeah.
I'm just like, just put it on.
Yeah. At that point, like
you're already doing the motion.
Yep.
Like, or the people that put it on and then they lift the strap and put it. So like they only have that one.
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah. Have fun getting cut in half.
Yeah. That's not, accident. That doesn't sound safe.
No, it's definitely not as safe to be doing that. But I used to know people that would do that. They would like put their seatbelt on and then yeah. they would take this part and just like lift it up over them so they only had, because they didn't like the feeling of that.
You're not going to like the feeling of being cut in half.
Yeah, you're not going to like sure. the feeling of being dead on the pavement. Well, I mean, you wouldn't feel it, I guess, but...
you wouldn't like
you
it,
You would
though.
For a while.
Yeah.
You'd be flying through the air like, I should have worn it.
That's exactly what you would be saying. I mean, I know I would.
Yeah.
Seatbelts, ladies and gentlemen, seatbelts.
I've just never had that urge to not wear one. Like,
never.
It's like,
I just
put it on. What's the fucking?
Fuck it, right? Might as well click it or tick it, right?
No, I wouldn't go that far.
So what happened with your tire?
PSI. Okay. So
was this with your last car?
No, this was with the Volt, the current one.
Okay.
I'm sitting there, and it's got the live tire pressure readouts.
Yeah.
Front driver tire is low.
Yeah.
So I'm like, oh, whatever. I'll just go. I've got a little pump. Mm-hmm. And you just plug into the cigarette lighter and like hook it up and it'll just pump it up.
Right.
So I'm in the garage, hit the button, turn it on. Now this thing has an auto shut off.
Right.
So it'll just turn off. Now when I fill my tires, I actually use KPA.
What does that mean?
It's the same. It's still a pressure measurement. It's the metric pressure measurement.
Okay.
I don't use PSI.
What is that? Kilometers?
It's kilos per some word.
Right.
Anti, I think, or something. I don't know. But so I'm filling it up, and I always use KPAs. But the thing is, to switch it to that, you have to like hold a button, and that, like it doesn't just remember that you had it on there.
Uh-huh.
I wasn't paying attention. It was set to PSI, and I started just like clicking the plus button.
Right.
And it's supposed to be 420 KPA for my tires.
Okay.
So I set it to 42 PSI.
Mm, you thought it was 4.
Because I thought it was 420 KPA. It was 42 PSI. So, you know, whatever, right? Like, 42 is not bad. I normally fill it to like, it's normally at like 38, mm-hmm. 36, 38.
Yeah.
So I'm like, all right, you know, what's a little extra?
Right.
It was cold out.
Okay.
Well, what happens to tires when it's cold and then you're driving? You ever watch your tire pressure thing in the winter?
Doesn't it go down?
It goes up.
Oh, it goes up.
So if your tires are cold,
mm-hmm.
like my car will read 33
okay.
on my tires. And I'll drive it for like 30 minutes, start getting heat in the tires from running on the road. The more I brake and stuff, my pressure starts going up.
Oh,
like
I've 36. Noticed that. I've noticed that before.
Because as you're driving, it makes heat, which
it
makes the air expand.
Right.
So
right.
I'm driving.
Little chemistry lesson, folks.
I'm driving 43.
Mm-hmm.
44.
Uh-oh.
45.
Uh-oh.
46.
Oh.
I'm like...
Did you hit the big 5-0?
I'm like panicking.
Yeah.
I'm totally. Like driving home from taking my roommate to work. No, it did. It hit 48.
48.
It was at 48. And I was like...
Shit.
I was like, all right, if it goes to 49, I'm going to pull over.
Yeah,
I'm gonna
get out my knife. You don't want it to... What are you going to do with the knife?
I'm going to get out my knife. I'm going to flip it open. I'm going to touch the tab and just and let out some air.
I'm going to get out. I'm going to slash my tires.
Stab my tire.
Get ahead
of
it.
No, I'm just going to take the knife. I'm going to poke the little thing, let some air out.
Right.
Driving, still at 48, still at 48. It just sat at 48.
Okay.
I got home,
mm-hmm.
immediately got out of the car, like panic, got out of the car. The tire was like... Going
was
like,
that shit? Was
like
that shit
to kind of bulge a little?
Oh man!
And I took I have a little pressure tester, and I just like lightly pressed it again, and it started letting air out.
Yeah.
Like I was like, holy fuck!
Did it feel like airy when you were driving?
The car was like,
did it feel like you were floating?
No, it was pulling because the one tire was so much bigger that it was like leaning. So it was like it was pulling to the side while I was trying to drive. Like I had to have the wheel a little turned.
Damn!
I was like.
Shit.
Having a panic attack that this tire was going to... like, I was... You ever... Okay. Is it ever like, you know, it's raining or there's like a thunderstorm?
Yeah.
And you'll be telling yourself, all right, thunder now. Okay. Uh-huh. Thunder now. Just to see if you get
I'm going to fucking die now.
Yeah. I was like, all right, tire's going to explode now.
Yeah.
Okay. Tire's going to explode now.
Was that like...
Tire's going to explode now. Like...
Where was that? On the expressway?
No, just the back roads, luckily. Dude, if I was on the expressway, I never would have done it. I would have pulled over. I would have aired that bitch out. Like, I would have rather driven lower PSI than higher.
I don't know if my tire would have lasted that much because it's like supposed to be 32. So like 48 is a
mine are supposed
while
to be like
away.
36 to 38. And my car starts bitching when it gets to 33 or 32. It'll like turn the light.
That's
like,
so interesting because my shit's like... 32 is like where it performs that. Like, that's like where it should
be. It's got to just be the tires. Like, because mine are, if you've ever seen my tires compared to yours, they're like.
Bigger, right?
Yeah, because I've got a smaller rim.
Right. So it's like the bigger the rim.
18s or 19s?
19.
Okay. Yeah. I've got like, I think 18.
Right.
So that matters. Like, there's a little bit extra room.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Maybe there's someone listening right now that works on cars. That's like, you're both fucking idiots.
Right.
This doesn't actually, that's not how it works. And I just fill my tires up more. But like, I look at the side of the tire and it's
it
like,
says to fill it up that.
Like the 35. Right?
But damn, 48. 36.
No, that's too... I fucked up.
Yeah.
I'm like...
Well, you live and you learn, right?
Because I was trying to figure out... Like, I wasn't even looking at the tire pressure thing. Because I never have that up. I always have... Because my car's got the little info HUD where you can press the down and up arrows. It'll change.
Yeah.
I keep it set to show my speed.
Right.
Because if that's not there, it shows your speed in tiny little numbers at the top. Like, I don't have a speedometer. It's all digital.
Right.
So, I keep it on the speed. Shows the speed, shows my compass heading.
Yeah.
And then I was just like driving and it started kind of pulling and I was like, what the fuck? So I like went to go check the tire pressure.
Yeah.
And it was like, excuse you. And
it
I was
all
like,
clicked.
I'm going to die.
When was that?
Well, it was beginning of winter, like in October, November, when it was starting to get like cold enough that we had like our first snow.
Damn.
And that's why I was driving and it started like going up and up and up and up. And I was like, this is how I die.
Well, you live to tell the story, so that's great.
Yeah, no, and it was a fun story. I learned a lesson. Check my tire pressure before I go anywhere.
I'm still thinking about Brain Box, man. I'm sorry.
Oh my God. It's a good movie. You got to watch it, though.
What could a Brain Box look like?
Does they it show it?
Yeah. And is it all brains that are, is it one brain?
It's like a stem. There's like a stem going up and then there's a bunch of stems branching off and then little stems.
See,
it looks like broccoli, dude.
But
it
you
looks
see
like
the
brain
broccoli. Brain broccoli.
Yeah, you see brains floating in there. It's like a glass box on the top and then there's like a black bottom part. That's
okay.
And then there's like all these hoses connected to it that are like people are sitting around laid back in chairs with the hoses like attached to their nose.
It just seems it.
And there's like a scene where when they take Owen Wilson's out and they like they pull it out. There's like these little tentacles all up in his nose and they pull him out. And then one's just hanging there and he's like, and he like, it like goes up into his head and shit.
It just seems so like, abstract for Owen Wilson.
Yeah.
Like,
see, like something more his pace. I also watched another movie.
Okay.
Called Secret Headquarters.
He's in this one?
Yes.
Another Owen Wilson.
Yeah. I watched another one. Amazon was just recommending him to me.
Yeah.
I was like, I don't got a problem. I love Owen Wilson. You know?
Yes.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah. He's wow. He's wow.
Wow. I loved him in Loki, and that's why I hadn't seen him in anything since then. So, and this one, he plays a superhero. It had, remember when I was telling you about the movie Zoom with Tim Allen, where he plays a superhero with the kids?
Is that this vibe?
Vibe, yep. He's playing a superhero. He's like a dad. He gets divorced from his wife because he's being a superhero and have no time now. And his kid's at his house and finds a secret lair with his friends.
Now, is this an old movie?
No, it's still newer. It's like after 2020.
Wow.
I'm not hearing
about any of these.
He finds his secret. This one, I think, was an Amazon original.
Ah, that's probably why.
I don't remember. But
I'm not tuned in very much to the Amazon.
They got some fire originals. Shit.
It's probably the only streaming service that I'm not like tuned in on.
Yeah, no, they got some fire shit on there for their originals. Like, we've been watching some shit on there, and it's actually pretty good. We watched there's a few good Chris Pratt movies on there. Tomorrow War. I think they made an Amazon original or like an Amazon exclusive Jurassic Park, or maybe it's just on there. I don't remember honestly.
Jurassic Field.
No. It was Jurassic Park, but it was like, or it was Jurassic World, but it was called like Dominion or something.
Okay.
It's like the last movie in the Jurassic World installments.
Interesting.
But so the secret headquarters.
Okay.
He plays a superhero. His kids find his secret lair, and then you know the bad guys, which is the U.S. government, because we all know those are the bad guys. They show up with their military guys, and they're like, "We gotta steal the power source." And then the kids are trying to like defend the secret base and
movie
protect
shit.
Them. Yeah, it had such a
movie,
had that
movie.
Family friendly, but like we're trying to be bad guys, family friendly. You know,
right, right.
A lot of guys getting kicked in the shins and stuff because the kids are like, "Take this, why?" You know. And, it was still funny. Like, I was still laughing at certain parts. It had some good comedy.
Was it kind of corny, though?
A little bit. But it was still worth the watch. Like, honestly, the VFX were actually really good. I was concerned because, like, with Zoom and, like, you know, those kid superhero movies, like, the VFX are always corny.
Well, yeah. Like,
but
fucking,
like,
what's the other one? Superhero High or whatever.
Yeah, Sky High.
Sky High. Like, yeah.
They're always corny, but like this one, because it's new enough and it looks like they had a bigger budget, like the VFX, the costumes are
Jeff
really well
Bezos
done.
Gave him a bag for it.
Yeah.
Seems.
This might not have been an Amazon original too, though. I don't.
Oh.
The problem is I confuse it because it has a little Amazon logo, but that could just mean like
it's streaming on it.
It's included with Prime, or it could mean like original until you roll over it. Then
it kind of makes sense that it's an original. Like, so is,
you've never heard of it.
Is Owen Wilson just in his corny movie bag right now? Is he like going through like Cage arc?
No, but see, like it wasn't that bad. It wasn't that corny.
Okay.
Like it was actually pretty decent.
Did you
for
look,
what it was.
Did you look at any like box office information on it? Like how it did?
I could right now. I would be curious if it is an Amazon original. Cause then
I want
to
know how much they spent and how much they made. And while you're saying that, I will sing a song.
Oh, okay.
I'm just kidding.
Oh, okay.
I have another movie, though, so I'm going
to wait. I like how it went from, oh, okay, to, oh, okay. I thought maybe you were going to give us a little tidbit of one of your new
jams.
New japs. Hold on. What was it called? Secret. I don't know how to spell secret, apparently. Secret headquarters.
You put an E at the end of secret, right?
No.
Or no, that's secrete.
Okay, 2022 comedy superhero movie, 1 hour, 44 minutes.
What's the budge?
There's not one listed. So it must not have went to box office, right? If they don't list that, so maybe it
type
was.
Type in, like, what is it called again? Well, superhero movie?
That would be on the IMDb, right?
Superhero Owen Wilson movie, right? Is that what it's called?
It's called Secret Headquarters, my guy.
Secret
Headquarters. Let me check the
Wikipedia. Secret Headquarters budget.
The film premiered at Signature Theater.
Right.
It was released in the United States the 12th of 2022 on Paramount Plus. Oh, this might have been like an exclusive to streaming then. Production.
Definitely.
It has no information about it. I don't think it had a box office. Like, I think it was just released for streaming. Yeah, distributed by Paramount Plus. So it wasn't an Amazon exclusive one.
Yeah.
But it was made for streaming, like Paramount Plus, which is probably why you didn't hear anything about it.
Interesting. I would have thought there was some information.
You know what? I am gonna just while you tell your thing, I'm gonna look up budget because I'm curious too.
I was gonna talk about another movie that I saw, but One thing, though, that I will say is apparently Netflix is like Netflix, and I'm sure other ones are super like gatekeepy about like how good movies do on their platform, even to the ones that are involved in it.
There's no box office performance information.
Yeah.
Obviously. The summary doesn't have anything about it. Yeah.
Let's just assume that it did okay.
I think it, yeah.
If it crushed it, I feel like it would have went past my radar, but there's really no way to know. Maybe I'll check it out, though. Sometimes you can just kind of tell.
Yeah, it's on Amazon, included in Prime, and if you still have my information, or if you have like a Paramount Plus, I guess it's probably.
I do. Yeah, I have someone's Paramount Plus.
I stole it.
Yeah. That's
like a modern day, like, that's the modern day crime. You steal someone else's streaming.
Well, apparently, like, Netflix doesn't want you to do that shit anymore.
Oh, yeah, yeah, they were talking about that.
But, like,
crackdown.
I mean, bro, what do you, like, okay, so what, when I travel and I'm at a hotel and I want to sign in, I can't? Like, that's just some bullshit, bro. There's no way they're going to go through with that.
There was a lot of stuff going on
online. And they're, like, raising price. I mean,
But that's not even, like, Netflix fucking raises prices every year.
Yeah.
Because they're in so much debt
right.
from, like, all the shows they make. Like, yeah. we talked about this. Like, what Stranger Things was, they got, like, $33 million an episode to make that. Like, are you fucking kidding? That's, like, a bigger budget than some movies.
Yeah, hell like, yeah. Hell yeah.
Which, I mean, you know, whatever. It's a good show.
Yeah.
I mean, not shit-talking Stranger Things.
I think Netflix just needs to...
They're too loosey-goosey.
It's just, it's weird, though, because... There must be, I mean, there's obviously a bunch of people sitting in a room trying to figure this out. And I guess what they think is that if they make it so people can't sign in different places, it'll increase the amount of new users,
which would increase their money. Right, because people won't be able to share stuff, so people will have to get. But the problem is.
That doesn't do, I don't think it would, I think
they're looking at. I don't think Netflix is worth it.
I think they're looking at numbers on a board and not thinking about practicality.
Because people would probably end up canceling over
this.
Yes, because
big time.
First off. And this is my hot take.
Yeah.
I don't think Netflix is worth it. If
I don't
didn't
think
have,
it's worth it anymore, yeah.
Yeah, if I didn't start my subscription back when it was only still $10,
yeah.
and now I'm paying like $19 or some shit.
Yep.
Like if I hadn't have started my subscription, I would not look at Netflix and go, I want this subscription.
Yeah.
Because aside from like Stranger Things and like The Witcher, like mm-hmm. they really don't have a capital on like any exclusives because all of the Marvel stuff is on Disney now.
Yeah.
Including what used to be. So like Iron Fist, Luke Cage, Daredevil, Jessica Jones, those used to be Netflix exclusives.
Right.
But now they're on Disney Plus because they were Marvel.
Yeah.
So it's like. They don't have that anymore.
Yeah, all their shit's getting snatched up. Like,
what's the point?
I've been on HBO Max way more, and HBO Max is only $15 a month.
Oh, and I love it. Yeah, I do like HBO Max.
Yeah, I just...
And Paramount Plus. I've been on that a lot. I've been on that Amazon.
Right? I think like Netflix Prime. Is just low-key falling off.
Yeah, I barely open the app anymore.
Yeah,
like,
true.
Like, barely.
Because it's more or less, it's like, now I go on Netflix... Just if I'm looking for something and I've gone through the pillars of like...
Yeah, you're not even my fourth choice.
Yeah,
like,
and then it's like after everything is tapped and I can't find the specific movie...
You just go on Netflix and watch some shit.
And well, to see if it's even there. But that's the thing is like now it's like... It just... They're not keeping up. Like HBO Max is like every time there's a movie in the theater, it's always same day HBO Max. Like... I mean, it's fucking HBO. Like, of course they're going to crush it in the streaming space. Like, it makes fucking sense. But I don't know, man. Netflix.
I'll say, like, Netflix is the... You know what I've been using it for the most is anime.
Mm.
They've got a big selection of, like, English-translated animes.
Mm.
But the other problem is I already have Crunchyroll, which is an anime service that has, they have simultaneous release. So, like, when an anime airs in Japan, it's released on Crunchyroll.
Boom, comes right out.
So it's like I barely even need Netflix for that anymore.
I'll be honest with you. I get my Netflix from a family member. And it's been six.
I think that's like everyone.
Yeah.
Except
it's,
me.
It's been like probably 6 years, I think, now. I haven't paid for Netflix for 1 month of the entirety that I've ever used it. But I will say that if I had to pay for it, I wouldn't.
Because no,
I pay for
too
like,
much.
I pay for HBO Max and like Hulu.
Yeah.
And then the rest I trade. But like.
I have the Hulu Disney bundle.
Right. We talked about that. Yeah.
That's
cool.
That's actually a pretty good deal.
Yeah, I'm not big on like the Disney Plus. I have a sign in for it. I'll like glance through it, but it's just
I might have one in my collection.
It's just like I don't know. I kind of fell off of that whole, like...
I do it for Marvel.
Okay.
Not even for Disney. Star Wars and Marvel are both on there. And they got some pretty fire Star Wars and Marvel shows. Hey, you know what we haven't talked about? Let's talk about Star Wars. So...
Isn't there like a new Star Wars thing going on?
I don't know. Is there? I actually... Despite how much we made jokes about me always bringing it up,
there's just always, like, I'm always hearing someone be like, did you see the new Star Wars thing?
Oh, yeah, there's one of the shows is going, Andor, I think it's called, or something. And then they've been releasing shows, so.
Yeah.
Actually, the biggest thing we ended up watching on Disney Plus was me and Mrs. Suit just watched Moon Knight. Moon Knight, yeah, it's Egyptian-based superhero, basically. Some guy that's got dissociative identity disorder. He has like a pact with the Egyptian god Khonshu, the god of the moon.
Okay.
And it gives him a healing suit that he can like summon on command, and he looks like a wrapped mummy with like a cape and a hood. And
whoa.
He like kills evildoers. I mean kills. Like this show doesn't pull punches. It's not like... Oh, look at me. I punched the bad guy and he's knocked out. Dude, like, takes a blade off of his chest and just shoves it through someone and kills them. Like,
whoa.
He's one of the heroes that actually kills bad guys. But the story is, like, super interesting because it's, like, rooted in, like, Egyptian lore. So they have, like, Taboret, which is, like, the hippo goddess that you get to meet. And they talk about, like, the Duat, the Field of Reeds, their whole afterlife.
Where is this on?
System. Disney Plus.
Because
it's a part of Marvel. They are supposed to be doing, so the other thing is like,
sounds interesting. Is it a show or is it
a show?
Okay.
6 episodes, an hour long each,
but it's just one season.
One season for now. They did say that so there's no confirmed season 2, but all the cast and crew has been in and out of Cairo, which is where they filmed a lot of it, was in Egypt.
Right.
So people are speculating and stuff.
Right.
They're thinking it might be in like phase 5 of Marvel to release a season 2.
Have you seen anything on this Joker 2 shit? Have you seen Joker 1?
No, I really want to.
Okay.
It's on my list. Where can I stream it?
Oh, shit.
Gotta be HBO, right?
I think HBO. Yeah, it's HBO. Dude, watch it. Like, it's... Dude, even
That's
watch
the one
it tonight.
With the, is that the one with Joaquin Phoenix or the other one?
It's so good. Yeah, Joaquin Phoenix.
Okay.
Didn't they do
another one too recently? Or?
Well, so when they did that, when the new Batman came out, there was like a small little like teaser when at the end of Batman, where like you hear like the Joker's laugh, which is kind of like insinuating that in the next Batman, he's going to be in it.
Robert Pattinson? Is that his name? Yeah.
That movie was good.
Yeah.
That was a good vibe.
I did not go into that movie with high hopes.
Really?
Yeah, no, just because I was like, cool, that's what we need, another fucking Batman movie. But
I liked the... out of anything, I really liked the cinematography, and I liked the vibe of it, and just like
I did
the music choice,
I liked the color grading, I liked the music, I liked the way they portrayed Gotham. Like
it was cool. No, it was.
And
I liked,
honestly, I wasn't sold on Robert Pattinson, but
he did it.
Know, yeah, he
did his thing.
He did it.
He did it. Yeah. No, I liked it a lot. I liked his little fucking, just everything about that movie was really cool. And the what's his name? The Riddler.
Yes.
He killed it.
Oh yeah.
Because, like, I mean, the last
Literally, Riddler, he killed a bunch of people.
The last Riddler we had was Jim Carrey, and he was great, but that was just such a slapstick version of,
But that's the thing. The Riddler's supposed to be kind of slapstick.
No, yeah.
But I think this Riddler, I don't know if you've played any of, like, the games?
Yeah.
Yeah, like, I think this Riddler stays a little more true to, like, the comics and the games. Where it's, like, not as, like, look at me, I'm throwing a squishy duck out of my butt. Wank, wank. Yeah. You know, like, Jim Carrey just kind of...
Here's a riddle. Yeah.
Jim Carrey... I can't say too much because I did really like him.
It was for the time. Like, that's the same
shit.
Yeah, for the
time.
Where it's like, you know, Danny DeVito being the Penguin.
Oh, my God. But Danny DeVito makes an amazing Penguin.
No, he does. I mean, he's built exactly like a Penguin.
Why was he not the Penguin again in this movie?
It just wouldn't have been the vibe. Like, it was... I forgot his name. The guy who did it. It's, oh, my God. No, it's a famous ass dude. No, he was really good.
He was good, yeah. But I just still, for some reason, I don't know why, but Danny DeVito just...
No, he
like,
killed it as the Penguin.
Yeah.
But like with the Joker, they're like, they've been filming, so they're in production for the second one. And there's been a bunch of footage of like them filming it. And there's been people like, because right now they're filming in LA, but they've been setting up props to make it look like, you know, Gotham.
Right.
So it's like...
But of course. Why film in New York or somewhere else where you could make it, where they actually use Gotham?
But I think it's because, like, because if you watch the first one, after you watch the first one, you should watch this, like, little, there's, like, a little behind the scenes on the VFX. And what they did was, because you know how, like, obviously Gotham doesn't exist. Yeah. So it's like they
well, they mix parts of Chicago and New York to make Gotham.
But they did a lot of cool, like, effects with the buildings. To like they like scaled them and like repeated them like in the background, so it looks like, you know, a street you've never seen basically, but it looks so real that like you feel immersed in it, like it feels real. And there was like fake like subways set up, so it was really cool because people were walking around and they were just filming like all the shit on the street, but it's all props. But you see like garbage and graffiti and like fake subway stations, but it's all for the movie. And there was this one sequence where the Joker's running through traffic and there's two Jokers following him, but it's like one of them is like him in his street clothes, the other one's like another version of him that's like taller. So people were like speculating that it was like some kind of dream sequence or something. Like, it just seems from what they're putting out that they're going like balls deep in this shit. Like, it looks really fucking cool.
Oh, I don't remember the name, but I gotta Google it. I'm sorry. I know I keep taking out my phone. There's a movie.
What is it?
Maybe you know. It's Nicolas Cage.
Yeah.
It's the one where he plays a young version of himself and an old version of himself. It's got Pablo Pascal in it. I don't know if it's in theaters. Hold on, Nicolas
Cage. I just remember there being a Will Smith movie like
Pedro
that.
Pedro Pascal movie. Yeah, that was Gemini.
Yeah.
That Gemini was an amazing movie.
Right.
I really liked that movie.
Isn't that like the same thing?
The Unbearable Weight of Massive Talent it's called.
Okay, no. I remember hearing about that. That like just came out, but I didn't think he played a young version.
Released April 22nd, 2022.
Wait, he played a young and an old version? I thought that was the movie
I think that's it. Or am I thinking of a different movie?
I thought that was the Nicolas Cage movie where he plays Nicolas Cage.
Yeah, but I think there's a younger version of himself in it or something at one point. Or maybe I am thinking of a different Nicolas Cage. Dude, I don't know. He's been in so many movies.
We talked about Dracula, right? Like the last episode.
Yeah,
like
I finally watched it. Yes.
You saw the preview?
Oh, it looks
it's going to
so
be so
good.
Funny, dude.
I'm so ready for
Renfield.
Renfield.
Yeah, yeah, that's going to be really cool. Man. What was I going to say? Oh, so, I mean, and you know, last episode was a food episode. Apparently, this one's a movie episode. Cocaine Bear.
No, he's in that. How Unbearable Weight VFX Team Made Nicolas Cage Young Again. There's a scene
maybe
where he's like a young version of himself or something.
That makes sense, though. The way you explained it.
No, there's two of him. He is driving the car as Nicolas Cage, and then there's him again, like younger. But I don't think it's like Nicolas Cage. I think he's playing another character in the movie that's supposed to be like him from Con Air. Like, he looks like himself from like the Con Air movie.
Huh.
I don't know. I really want to see it. It looks interesting.
When you explained it, because I've been seeing memes from it. There's a meme where
my friend in the car listening to my music. Yeah, that's with Pablo and Nick.
That's like, but that's the same movie.
Yes, that is the same movie, but that's not the scene. There's like another, I don't know. I got to see it.
Because when you just said it.
You thought like he was like he looked younger.
I instantly thought of Gemini Man. I thought it was going to be Nicolas Cage versus younger Nicolas Cage, which would be insane.
It's versus. I think it's like he just plays another character that's called like Nick or something, and it's supposed to be like the young version of him. Or
and is this like a dream sequence that he's having, or is this real?
I've never seen it. I don't know.
Okay.
I really want to see it. So if I manage to see it before the next episode. Yeah. I'll tell you where to watch it, and I'll have to, fill you in.
Well, let's end this off on Cocaine Bear.
Okay.
Because this is the movie I was talking about at the beginning that I saw in the theaters.
Okay, right.
So, first...
Cocaine Bear?
Cocaine Bear.
What kind of fucking name? Bird Box, Cocaine Bear?
No, this is exactly what you would think. It's not some... It's
cocaine?
It's not a metaphor for something. It's so literally a bear that... does cocaine.
Oh, it's a bear that does cocaine. I thought it was like a drug trafficking movie, like they filled like teddy bears with cocaine or something.
So okay, first and foremost, I just want to say RIP Ray Liotta.
Okay,
he's in the movie.
Oh, all right. Is that like his last movie? When was this movie from? It's got to be new, right?
This is his last movie that's out, at least. I don't know if he did anything else, which I just got to say, like, what a wild movie to end on.
I mean, from the title alone, this sounds interesting.
So
What's the vibe? Horror movie? Action?
It's a comedy movie.
Oh, it's a comedy. Okay.
Like, it has action and it has whatever, suspense. And mystery and thrill. But, like, at the end of the day,
it's about a bear doing cocaine.
It's like a stupid comedy movie. But it's like, okay, so, you know, it starts off basically where there's a dude. It hits right off the bat. There's a dude that's like, it's set in the 80s, by the way.
Okay. So that makes sense.
Peak of, cocaine. And this dude's in a plane and he's like throwing like duffel bags out of a plane. And it's because the plane's going down.
Okay.
And that, you know, his boss or whatever told him, if the plane goes down, throw it over this forest or whatever the fuck. So
I'm guessing the duffel bags are full of cocaine.
Yeah.
And the bear is going to find these.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's the whole movie, essentially, is the bear just finds him and starts eating them. And
a movie about a cocaine fueled bear.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm surprised you haven't heard anything about it.
No, I've not. Not even on YouTube or Google or that's so crazy.
What's funny is that it's got a cast in it. Like, it's not some ridiculous indie movie.
You know them.
Yeah. Yeah. Ray Liotta. Ice Cube's son. I forgot his name, but Ice Cube's son.
That's how they credit him.
He looks exactly like Ice Cube. It's crazy. And his son is cool and he did a good job. And it's interesting that he just skipped music and went right to movies. Because Ice Cube music,
yeah, he did,
then
music,
movies. He just said, fuck it, go right into movies. And he's doing his thing. And then
what was Ice Cube? Was it Are We There Yet?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a good, that's an old one.
It's kind of like he's kind of getting into that bag. He's trying to figure that little lane out and it's working for him. And he was in, Ice Cube's son was literally played Ice Cube in a movie. I think it was Straight Outta Compton.
Oh.
So he's killing it though. Shout out him. Mm-hmm. I forgot his name. I'll be honest with you. I'm going to look it up after this. But either way, Cocaine Bear,
Ice Chip.
Huh?
Ice Chip.
Yeah.
Ice Chip.
Ice Chip
off the old block.
So it's Ice Chip and then his buddy. See, what's weird about the movie is it goes in, it starts going in different directions where you think it's going to be a different way and then it's not. So first off the bat.
It's like misdirection.
I didn't think that there was going to be so much gore in the movie. Motherfuckers are getting ripped in half and shit.
That's kind of weird.
You don't think that it's going to be that way just because it feels a little more lighthearted than that. And then there's the first kill scene, you see it and it's wow, this motherfucker just got ripped in half by a bear and he's just dead now. It's they showed the whole thing and,
they just kind of threw weird bone on that one.
Yeah.
Whoa.
It was interesting. And so basically, you could already imagine, right? There's cocaine involved. So there's a guy trying to find the cocaine and that's where Ray Liotta comes in. You know, he's the cocaine boss and he's where is this bear? Blah, blah, blah. Now it's basically a wild goose chase to try to find this bear, but you got Cocaine Bear who's just killing everyone on a rampage. Because of the cocaine. And then you got the dudes that are you got rangers or whatever you call them, the forest rangers,
the park rangers.
They're trying to get the bear. And then you got this dude trying.
Not more worried about the cocaine?
No, they're just trying to
I guess because the bear is killing people.
Yeah. So this bear's on a rampage. A
little more important, I guess.
They're not over here oh man, we got to get this cocaine. But Ray Liotta.
This cocaine trade.
Ray Liotta doesn't care about the bear or it's what it's doing.
No, he just wants his drugs.
Yeah, because it's apparently millions and millions of dollars in cocaine.
And the bear's snorting it all.
He's not even eating it. Literally whatever. By the brick. you see the bear grab it and just force it in its mouth, the whole brick, bro. I'm like, damn. Yeah.
I think in real life that might have killed a bear, but.
Yeah, no, there was some funny scenes. There's this one scene where the bear just straight up passes out on top of a dude. So the guy's sitting there and the bear just falls asleep.
And all the cocaine.
It's you're going to have to watch this preview because it's insane. But they do my dude Ray Liotta so dirty at the end. And this is obviously a spoiler. My dude gets his fucking entrails ripped out by some cubs.
Oh, not even the bear?
No, it's the bear's family.
Oh, they also fueled on cocaine?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And he gets his, literally they're eating his intestines and then he just falls off the side of a fucking waterfall.
And that's Ray Liotta. Like, I'm like, dude, they did my dude so dirty. Can you imagine that being your last movie? Like, I hope he had something else in the works, because like, it's like they killed him off of the cinematic universe and he happened to die in real life.
The death in the movie was so shameful that
I hope he didn't go out like that in real life, bro. That would be insane.
Killed by a cocaine fueled bear's family.
Yeah, like I was like, wow. I mean, no, it was, all jokes aside though, the movie was like okay at best. Like, I think
it's like the best you get from that style of movie.
Yeah, like I thought that it was going to be actually a lot worse than it was. Like, I thought it might have been.
So you went in with like those lower expectations.
Yeah, like I thought it was going to be some like, he's right behind me, isn't he? Like, I thought it was going to be really corny. And it had some like goofy parts in it. But it felt like it was a movie that I feel like needed to happen, where like there's not enough like really stupid movies nowadays coming out at a mainstream level. So I think it just needed to happen.
We just needed a movie with a cocaine fueled bear family. Yeah. There's not enough of those.
No, there's not. I mean, it was.
That's probably the only one.
It was creative. And
did Winnie the Pooh snort cocaine?
No.
Then that is the only one.
He should have.
That's dude, that's what we call like cornering a niche market.
Seriously.
Like, yeah. Cocaine fueled bear genre. Like,
first of its kind.
Seriously. So that's something right there.
Yeah, it was funny. And like, I feel like there was a point in time where they could have went with the buddy comedy trope with what's his name? Ice Cube's son? Ice Chip and his buddy. They could have went on some, like, I thought it was going to be more about them too, because they're, it's like, there's three different separate storylines happening, right? Like, you got like those dudes who they're like the henchmen for the cocaine guy, for Ray Liotta.
Okay.
You know, they're like, they're working.
Okay, and I could see how that would give that like buddy.
Yeah.
Buddy,
you know, like, feel. It's like, he's over here. Cause one like of the guys
Stooges
is
shit or something.
It's Ray Liotta's son. That's okay. Like, so it's Ray Liotta and his son, and then Ice Chip, they're both like trying to get the cocaine, and because they work for him.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you got that side of it, and then like I said, you got the park rangers, and it's just all this whole thing, and then but just the way that this bear just straight up like attacks motherfuckers, and they just show it, all of it, it looked pretty real. The CGI, obviously it's not a real bear, right, was good, and then sometimes it wasn't. Like,
I mean, at least it wasn't a dude in a bear costume.
Yeah, which could have been funny, you know. But no, they had more. This was definitely way higher budget than Winnie the Pooh. I mean, this was way better than that. What's weird is like the close up shots of the bear looked better than the far away shots, because when they were dealing with like the motion of the bear, it looked a little rough. Mm. But like up front, because there were scenes where like the bear was right in front of your face, and they had it. I mean, it's a daunting task. You have to create the image of like a bear doing cocaine and like covered in cocaine. Like, there's a scene where he's like just covered in it.
I like to imagine. So do you know a lot about the VFX behind the scenes kind of stuff, like how that works?
Yeah.
So like, you know,
I wouldn't
you got,
say the
you
term
got,
a
like,
lot is
you got like, okay, so you got these guys.
Yeah.
They go out, they got their cameras, they shoot all the shots.
Yeah.
And then they hand over fact data sheets.
Yeah.
That have like the cameras make, the model, the sensor width, sensor height, depth of field, focus, poles, like all the information.
Yeah.
They just hand over. Can you just imagine? There's a VFX crew. They get handed over some fact sheets. You're like, all right, here's the storyboard. The bear doing cocaine.
It's probably exciting, honestly. I mean, think about all the fucking, the shit they're working on that's not that.
Right, yeah.
If that comes across my table, I'm in. Like,
right,
I'm interested.
Yeah, it's like that ability to do something, like, outlandish.
Yeah.
Like, whoa, a bear doing cocaine. That sounds hilarious. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's like when you come to me and you're like, I need some stupid shit done. And I'm like,
fuck it.
Yeah. Like, I got, yeah, that sounds fun.
Yeah, man. I mean, it's like, it's a funny movie. It's not, it wasn't bad.
Bear doing cocaine and Billy music video when?
Sheesh. Well, we would have to obviously do CGI.
Yeah, or just put a guy in a bear costume.
Could be. I'm trying to see Cocaine Bear 2. When is that coming out?
I don't know. Do you think there would be a second one? Did they give any inclination?
No, everyone pretty much just died.
What about the bear, though?
Did the bear die?
Because if the bear didn't die, it is very possible he's about to go Tony Montana on their ass. Or not, no, sorry. Inigo Montoya.
Yeah.
I just said Tony Montana.
I'm imagining Tony Montana Bear now. I mean, that kind of makes sense. Like, now he's the drug lord.
Right.
Yeah.
The bear's just sitting there like...
Yeah.
He's got like a fucking mountain of cocaine and just like money everywhere.
I think.
Like bitches, like bear bitches.
I think he did survive. I don't know why I feel like he, because I don't know if he just.
We need a Scarface reimagining with this bear.
Yeah. Yeah. No, there's this one.
Whoever's listening right now, like big Hollywood producers listening right now, because obviously we're so famous.
You
like,
know they're watching.
Give us a call.
Bro,
just saying.
The worst kill in that movie. Okay, the one that like made me go, ow. Right? It wasn't the entrails being ripped off and being thrown off a waterfall. It wasn't the dude hanging off a tree with his fucking like literally cut in half. It was by the way, that was insane. Let me just mention
this fucking bear, man.
Dude, so what happens is the dude, he was actually from Modern Family. I forgot his name. He is just one of the park rangers.
Mm.
Climbs up a tree and he's like, yeah, we're safe up here. Bears can't climb trees. The guy's like, bears can climb trees. This bear like smells the cocaine on the guy because when the guy was running from the bear, he fell in the cocaine. Okay. So now the bear smells the cocaine on him, runs from the other tree, runs to this dude, pulls his legs off. Okay. And just now his legs fall. And then he's just like, just hanging there, holding on by his arm, and his body, he's looking down and the rest of his body is just gone because the bear ripped it off. That wasn't as bad as the park ranger lady. Okay. And she was in a couple other things. You would know if you saw her. She's been in a bunch of shit. She, basically, gets like kind of fucked up by the bear, but not crazy. Like just kind of a couple slashes. And she's like, the EMS comes to take her. And they're driving away. This bear, because there's cocaine residue in the fucking truck, jumps in the while they're driving, like a 30-foot lunge into this thing, and just fucks everyone up in the EMS truck. And the lady's on a stretcher. Okay, he pushes her off. She falls off the stretcher, face first onto the cement. And for like 50 feet is just getting like scraped.
Dragged. Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. And they show it. That's what's crazy is they like,
they just showed went all out it. With his gore.
Yeah. Yeah. It, and like, it was just like, it like made
somebody
you,
in the prop department was like,
fuck it. Let's go.
Let's
nuts.
Do it. I got makeup.
Yeah. Like I heard a audible gasp from the audience when I was at the theater. Cause it was opening night. Everyone was like, and like laughter. And it was just like, bro, that shit made me like, I was like, oh dude, whoa. That was a lot.
You can't just be coming at me with that. You gotta give me a warning.
It was a whole lot of it. It's when like, when horror movies or anything shows what you think is not going to be shown. That's when you're like, whoa.
Yeah.
Okay.
Whoa. You can't do that.
Yeah. But they did it. They did it. Cocaine Bear, man. Go see that shit. But I don't know, man. Send them home. Okay. Do
it. All right. We hope you guys enjoyed 44. Was this 40? I feel like this is 44. Man, we are cruising through this with you guys.
Yeah,
so if you guys
sure.
enjoyed the video, go ahead and give it a like. Make sure to leave a comment down below. Tell us which Batman movie is your favorite. And if you liked Danny DeVito as the Penguin, because I think that's popular. Dude, nobody, what am I saying? Everyone that watches this is so young. They're going to be like, what's a Danny DeVito?
No, come on.
Yeah, I don't know. Leave a comment. Give us a like. You know, we really appreciate it. It helps us out a lot. If you want, you can click over him. That's going to give you the video YouTube recommends for you. Click over me. That's going to give you the playlist of all the episodes. And you can click up on our sign. That's going to let you subscribe to the channel. We enjoyed having you guys and see you later.
Peace out.